That's why that King James Bible is unique, because it does give a definition between love and charity.
Amen.
It's the definition between love and charity. And it's very common today for people to have this personal relationship with Jesus. We should have a personal relationship with the King James Bible. And I don't mind calling him Jimmy. So sometimes I refer to old Jimmy, and that's what I'm talking about.
Amen.
Brother, you mentioned grace oftentimes, and I find it ironic that your believer, your heretic hunter, your fault finder, will have more grace for a homo than you and I.
Right.
You and I are damned. We're going to hell.
Amen.
But a homo, they get more grace than we do. You know, it's if you take your eyes off of God, you can become so bitter. I should be an atheist. Most atheists, when you actually remove evolution and science, they've saw the hypocrisy. And as Pastor Dave said, you know, 40 years of service, you see a lot of things. And so I got saved in 1979, started preaching in 1980. I didn't think I was going to be this old doing this. I didn't think I was going to even see much in my lifetime. And so the things that we saw, and what makes it easier so I don't dwell on that is I back up and I think, poor God. All that I know is very little.
That's right.
From God's perspective, boy, he's upset with his church that's slandering and arguing and backbiting. Imagine if they just spent that time motivated just to go preach.
Right.
They would have had revival.
Right.
And so it's very easy to get bitter when people do things. Hey, try to have 25 churches come out against you. Doesn't make you feel very good.
Unbelievable.
Doesn't make you feel very good. When they're out there, you know, by the multitudes speaking against you. And like anything else, it fades away. It was just emotion. And after about a year and a half, they were gone. They dispersed. We're still there. But if I was in it for me, I would be so depressed, I'd be taking antidepressant drugs.
Yeah.
I believe the book. It happened. We've been reading Martyr's Mirror. Oftentimes, Catholics always bang their chest saying that they're the only church. Well, if you read Martyr's Mirror, there's a group called the Anabaptists.
Yep.
Those are some pretty tough boys. Those guys are getting killed. They hated some of them so much. The Catholics killed them, buried them, pulled up their bones, smashed their bones, burned them again, and then, you know, threw them in the water. That's how angry they were against these guys. But oftentimes it's Catholicism. They're the ones that always get told that they've been around for quite some time. Now, there's a little bit more history than that. Pastor, you mentioned about 5 years. You know, a Christian 5 years old should have enough common sense.
Sure.
And should have enough wisdom. And I know this is probably going to get me a hate mail. But we have Mongoloids among us.
Mongoloids.
There are spiritual Mongoloids. They are 30 years old and still piss their pants. They are 30 years old and they still need to be spoon-fed.
Bottle.
They may walk and look somewhat normal, but they're spiritual Mongoloids. They've been around for 30, 40 years, and they still bicker and argue. They are spiritual Mongoloids. And let me tell you this, because I know the hate mail's coming. Jesus said, let the blind lead the blind.
That's what he said.
In the ditch.
Yeah.
Boy, imagine if that statement was said today. Oh, man, you'd have the Braille Institute picketing Jesus everywhere he went. How dare you need to apologize for making that statement, poor blind people. That's what Jesus said. Let the blind lead the blind. They're both going to fall in the ditch. I don't apologize for what my Jesus said.
Amen.
And so what we have, brother, you're right. 5 years old, you ought to have enough common sense to know what's worthy of an argument. I don't mind getting in a good old-fashioned argument. That's not a problem. I can do it. But I do mind when there's times where it's not feasible. There's too many people walking, and you might do some hindrance. I want to end with this verse, and then we'll break off. Turn with me to 2 Timothy chapter 4. It's a Bible verse you're all familiar with. And even if you don't have a King James Bible, when I believe something, it's not just because of one Bible verse. I can prove my point by using a living Bible. I'm not limited to King James just for me. And so this is why, hey, it doesn't matter. I can still make a point. You want to show that Jesus is God? It's not necessarily in the King James. I can use another translation and still show it to you. It's still there. So I'm not limited to just King James only. However, King James, it does show that other translations, things were omitted. But nevertheless, there's verses where I can use other translations to make my argument. I'm not limited to just the King James. If some guy believes a particular translation, not a problem. I've studied enough Bible to use his own sword to prove the point.
Amen.
If all I did is believe a particular theology based on one Bible verse, I don't have much to grab. But there's numerous verses and examples why I believe what I do. It's not just one verse. 2 Timothy chapter 4, verse 2. Preach the word. It doesn't say preach the gospel. It says preach the word. And the reason why it says preach the word is it gives us license to cover 66 books.
Amen.
Many of our critics say, brother, stick with the gospel.
Red letters only.
It's just gospel. Most of them don't even know what the gospel is.
Yeah.
They'll tell you the gospel is John 3:16.
That's right.
They'll tell you, they'll come up with all kinds of stuff on what the gospel is.
Amen.
The gospel's the remedy, but the Bible says preach the word. Uh-huh. There's a lot of issues I can cover with this 66th book.
Amen.
This is the word of God. Preach the word. Goes on to say, be instant in season and out of season.
Oh boy.
Just even when you think you shouldn't. Well, brother, I just don't feel led to. I can care less what your feelings are. Let's go preach. It has nothing to do with your emotion or feelings. Let's go preach. Oftentimes you get some young believer who loves to go out and open air preach, and he loves to talk about how he got to this place. And he's trying to convince the sinners what took him to be here. Oh, you guys have no idea how much I love you. I had to go here and do this just to be here. Who cares why we're there? You never had anybody in the Bible show up and say, hey, you guys have no idea what it took. Jonah never went around Nineveh saying, you have no idea why I'm walking these streets and how I even got here. The Bible says, preach the word, in season, out of season, even when you think it's a time that you shouldn't. There are some guys that are repenting in their sin, and I work with these guys. Brother, you're on probation. We're not going to have you do much preaching, but you're worthy enough to hold a sign. You're worthy enough to be a security. I'll find a job. That's my function.
Amen.
I'll quarterback a job. We'll get you going. But don't hammer yourself down. We're there to actually build this guy up. Mm-hmm. He's not going to be the main speaker. And again, there's a lot more in-house police than what most people will ever know, because we work with such a large group of people. Preach the word. Be instant, in season, out of season, even when you think you shouldn't do it. Here's the good part. Here's the one that most street preachers know. Rebuke!
Yeah, tell them, man.
Oh, this is good. Love this verse. Exhort. Oh, yes. Then it goes on to say, with all long suffering. Now, you may not know what long suffering is, but again, God gave us this inspired Bible with words that we can understand. Suffering. And not just suffering, long suffering. If you disagree with J.K. or John Williams, just because he said something wrong that you disagree with, and you want to abort your your relationship with this man, there is no long suffering. I'm sure glad God was very long suffering with everyone in this room and those listening right now.
Amen.
The camera. Long suffering. You are going to suffer and put up with hanging around with Brother David from Alaska. And he's worth it. You may not agree with him. You may not like what he says or how he preaches or some costumes that he wears when he goes on the matches. But insert the word long with this suffering. It's in the Bible. This is God's terminology. This is what's unique about that Bible. Have long suffering. Today, you know, I disagree with him. I don't want to have anything to do with him. I don't like what he said. He's a heretic.
That's right.
There's no more long suffering. We got the rebuke and the exhort down. That's not a problem. With all long suffering and doctrine.
And
that's the concept. Are you willing to actually sit down and go over these things? Or would you just watch a 10-minute video and conclude everything about this guy? Long suffering. It's in the book. Have you suffered by even associating with this guy? Even though you disagree with him, even though your stomach turns, you might even hate his voice. But just long suffering there. It's in the book. It's there. God is a perfect example of long suffering.
Amen.
And I'm glad God's been very long suffering with so many people. If God treated people the way some of these street preachers treat people, we'd be in pretty bad shape. Very bad shape.
Mm.
So that's a good verse.
Amen.
On preaching. We got the rebuking down. What about the long suffering with this guy? Like I said, Jim Weber and I, we disagree on so much stuff. Most of you guys wouldn't have a clue how much Weber and I might argue on things. Because it's all done behind the scenes. It's not going to be a video. It's not going to be something that, in fact, most of the time Weber and I will agree on publicly and disagree. Hey, brother, I still disagree with you on that. Because that's how we operate. We are trying to unify people and get people together. And this street preacher community is growing more than most people will ever do. We've got about 78 chapters just in our group. Nationwide. More worldwide. So it's big, it's growing legs, but when you meet some people, or you read some people, or hear from some people, we're shrinking. Nothing is further from the truth. It's growing. People do see a need for it. And people are looking at those who are arguing against us and concluding, it is those guys. They're debating over everything. That's a cat. Well, I don't think so, brother. It looks like a raccoon. No, I don't think it's a raccoon. I believe it is a cat. They'll argue over everything. Preach the word. Be instant. In season, out of season, reprove, rebuke, exhort with all long-suffering and doctrine. That word long-suffering is something we need to bite and chew. That's what our Jimmy says. We need to bite and chew that. Amen. Are we really suffering with each other? And then add that long in front of it. Mm. That would be the definition of long-suffering. God is extremely long-suffering. Like I said, so you know, the early church, all of the issues that we had in the early church, here's a guy sleeping with his mother-in-law in one of the epistles. Yep. Yeah, there's some sin going on. God didn't just wipe him out. He was extremely long-suffering. Mm. And so I'm thankful for that, because that's why you and I are here, because he's long-suffering.
Amen.
We'll go ahead and break, spend a little time in fellowship, and hoping that you're enjoying yourself. Who needs a microphone at a street preacher's conference? You don't need a microphone when you got street preachers.